pull up, eh? Oh, Rob, actually, wait, let me come a little forward. There's an owl in the back as well, you see it? Can you get it there? Oh, no. That's still there. Looking at different ones. Let me go a little bit forward, maybe. It's about the same spot there. Now, if you go, Rob, go down and left. Down and left. There you go. Just under the two branches. Interesting that there were two. I didn't see the one that you saw flying away, Rob, but typically these guys are by themselves. Very territorial birds now. This one isn't displaying at the moment, but I didn't see the other one. Quite often they sort of bob the tail up and down. It's part of a visual display, and then obviously the call as well. Bull spotted owls making the sort of a long, continuous, not continuous, sort of a drawn out whistle that they build up. Don't want to make the sound now because that will agitate this one quite a bit. A tiny little owl, smaller than the size of, or about the size of the palm of your hand. Another thing that's very cool about these little owls is they've got like a fake pair of eyes on the back of their heads. The easiest way to think of it is like moths often. You see on moths' wings they have the sort of fake eyes. It's very much like that. The logic behind this is just that pearl-spotted owls are more active in daytime than most other owls, which to an extent leaves them open to predation from certain of your other raptors, some of your hawks and smaller eagles. So having eyes on the back of your head, as you can imagine, even if they are just fake ones, can help them be a little bit safer. Maybe a hawk sees it and thinks, no, I've already been seen. I'm not going to try and catch that one. Little pearl spotted owl, a nice surprise. Stopped to look at a squirrel and saw this. We're going to head towards Gowrie Dam, see what's happening that side.